Hello everyone, my name is Rohit and welcome to my channel. As you know, building product these days is easy. Anyone can build product with the help of AI, but making money from that product can be a bit tricky. For example, if you build your mobile app and want to monetize it, placing ads is one of the easiest way to do so. However, in the initial phase of your app development, your user base will likely be low. If you choose to use Google Ad Mob to monetize your app with a low user base, Google may revoke your access to ads. That's why I prefer to use Monetag, which allow you to monetize anything. In this video, we will see how to use Interstitial Ad and Push Notification Ad using Monetag in the React Native and Expo apps. I will also make the source code public, so do check out if you need any help, but follow the video carefully. But if you still face any issues, then do comment here or DM me on my social media handles. The links are in the description. So without any further delay, let's get started. Initialize an Expo app and name it whatever you want. In this case, I will name it test ad. Let the dependencies finish downloading for now. We only need to install one external npm package, so navigate to the test ad directory and install the package using the command npm install notix-rn. This is the default code for an Expo app, however I will make some changes to the text and style it a bit. Since I am using a native package that I have already installed, I will use the development build to run and test our Expo app. We will follow the official docs for this process. The official docs recommend installing a few packages such as EAS CLI and Expo Dev Client. Follow the video to install them one by one. Next, we will log into our Expo account using the EAS login command. If you don't have an Expo account yet, visit expo.dev and create one first. Next, we will create a build using this command. Copy and paste it into the terminal window. Sometimes you may encounter errors while building your apps due to poor internet connection, server issues, or poor management of components. However, if you work on these issues, you shouldn't face any problems. In any case, you will need to wait a few minutes for the build to finish. In my case, the build was complete after about 20 minutes and the terminal window displayed a QR code. We are going to scan this QR code using our phone's camera. As you can see on my mobile screen, I am not using any Expo Go app. So using my phone camera, I scanned the QR code. It took me to a screen where I saw an install button. I clicked on it and installed this APK. Next, we have to import the Expo dev client at the top of the app.js file. We are using the latest Expo SDK version 49, so we just have to run the command npx expo start to run the development server. Scan this QR code as well and copy the result and paste it into the development server manually. Okay, we are now testing the app code using the development build mode. Next, we are going to set up our Monetag account. To do this, go to Google and search for Monetag. Click on the monetag.com link. If you don't have an account, create one quickly. If you have a downloadable link to your mobile app or a Google Play link, simply paste it here. I will continue with localhost for now. If localhost doesn't work in the future, add a legitimate link here. If you don't know how to do that, continue watching this video, you will learn how to do it. Verify your account and create a password for your Monetag account. Okay, this is your Monetag account dashboard. We are now setting up ads for an Android device, so click on add new Android app. Here the daily active user count should be greater than 1000. Again, here you can add your Google Play link to the app or any other direct downloadable link. If you don't know how to do that, don't worry. When I was learning Expo, I built this app and published it to the Play Store. So I simply clicked on share and copied the shared link and pasted it here. But here is one trick. If you go to the app.json file and scroll down, you will see an Android package name. Simply copy this and replace it with the shared link package name. You can actually do this with any app. Copy any app shared link and replace it with your package name. Pretty simple, right? Simply give your app a name and set the daily active user count to greater than 1000. First, we are going to add the interstitial ad. So click on the ad format of interstitial ad. We will need this zone ID in our code. The Monetag team provided some pretty good documentation. You can follow it. But for a clearer idea of how it's done, you can follow the video carefully. First, we will start by importing the required components. I declared a variable named interstitial loader, which will be used to store a reference to an interstitial loaded object. Next up, we have a useEffect hook with a callback function as the first argument. Here we call a loadInterstitial function, which is defined later in the code. This function is responsible for creating an interstitial loader, starting the loading process and showing the interstitial ad when it's ready. The empty array means that the useEffect hook will only run once, after the first render of the app component. Next, we have an async function named loadInterstitial, which is an arrow function. We will use the zone ID here, so copy the zone ID and paste it here. This function is responsible for loading interstitial ads. It creates an interstitial loader, starts loading, waits for data for up to 5000 milliseconds, and shows the ad using the notix library. Save the code changes and you will see the interstitial ad on your device screen. Every time you reload your app or make any changes to your app, the interstitial ad will display. Interstitial ad is one of a kind. Next, we are going to set up push notification ad. The push notification ad will display as a notification on the user's device. Whether the user is using your app or not doesn't matter. Call a function called initialize push notifications here first. The initialize push notifications function initializes push notification by providing the notix app ID and token. Now we need a notix app ID and notix token. For this, go to your Monetag ad section and click on add format. Then set up the push notification ad. If you click on how to configure, then it says that we have to make a Firebase account because it uses the cloud messaging API of Firebase. So let's quickly set up a Firebase account. Click on get started and click on add a project and name your project. Here click on settings, then click on project settings. After that, click on cloud messaging. Cloud messaging API legacy is disabled, so let's enable it. Click on these three vertical dots and then click on manage API in Google Cloud Console. Here you just have to click on enable and wait for it to be enabled. Next, go back to the Firebase and refresh your page. Here you will see your server key and server ID. Copy these keys and ID and paste them into the Monetag push notification input field. Click on save and continue. After that, click on install integration for the push notification. We will use this token and ID in our project. So quickly copy and paste it into your project. Perfect. allow the notification service to access your application. Now wait for at least 2 to 3 minutes, the push notification ad from Monetag will pop up. I am adding a screenshot so you can see how long it takes for the push notification to pop up on your device. You can see that you will receive an ad push notification every 15 to 20 minutes. It's a great source of income, to be honest. So that's it for this video. In this video, we saw how to set up interstitial ad and push notification ad using Monetag in React Native and Expo app. If you have any issues, then feel free to comment here or DM me on my social media handles. The links are in the description. Thanks for watching and see you soon in the next React Native and Expo video.